have to do myself.
Hi, welcome to Life is Mimi. And today we're going to talk about life matters. This came to me in a message from God. And it was, you know, that life matters. That everyone needs to understand the seven aspects of God. And that this is your best mental diet that you can have, and how it takes care of so many things. It takes care of everything, okay? It takes care of everything. And the Bible tells you this in the story of Joshua and bringing down the walls of Jericho. These walls at the time were considered to be impregnable. You can't get past them, you know, and it would be impossible. And God tells Joshua how to do it. And the symbolism in it is the seven, you know, and you're using the ark, your mind, you know, and you do this for 7 days, okay? And then you focus on these aspects, a different aspect every day, one or two, you know, a day. Whatever works for you. Love is incorporated throughout it all. And this is the one that I've been focusing on, because that's the root, is divine love. So love, you know, God is love, okay? And God is life. Love expresses itself as life, you know? But what a lot of people don't understand is God is life. You know, it's what I mean by he's everyone and everything. He's your mouse. He's the ashtray you put cigarettes out in. He's the cigarette you smoke. It's life. You've been told it's inanimate. No, it's not. It's life. This is all God. And matter is an expression of God in a limited way. So God put himself into man, he went into the limit of contraction. This is what Nebuchadnezzar was speaking about here, the limit of contraction. And God's inside you, and he's inside each one of us individually, and you can look it up. That means it can't be divided, it can't be destroyed, you know, you can't break it, you can't tear it apart. You can shape it with the baby, and man and the baby are one, mother and child. Man in the human imagination, which is what, again, Neville was stressing. You go to the Son to get to the Father. However, the Bible tells you, you know, how to train the human imagination. Okay? That's what it's telling you. This is the handbook. Okay? This is how you train yourself to imitate your Father. And in the process, you know, then you're going to come together, each individual, you know, individualized expression of God in this limited body, you know, and express life, these aspects of God. God is life. God is love. You know, God is everything. So the man is part of God, but the man is not bigger than God. The human imagination and the man are part of God, but they're not bigger than God. And God is it. And that's your consciousness. And yours is whole and complete with all the powers and beauties in these seven aspects of God. So, life matters. And this is the message that's being given by all this, ugly that's been going on. And everyone needs to recognize that life matters. God is life. God is the blades of grass, each one individually and as a whole. This is what science has shown you and has told you. Science calls God mind, and that it's made up of two parts, the conscious and the subconscious. It leaves out the pituitary gland. That's science, the story. Okay, but that's no different than, really the Bible. And it's had to be clarified with the New Testament and showing that Jesus is the human imagination and this is all love. And if you focus man and baby on the human, use your human mind and your human imagination to focus on the seven aspects of God. There's nothing that can, stop you in any way, shape, or form. And so life, God is life. Each blade of grass is different, but they all make up, the sea of grass. Each droplet of water in the ocean is different, but it makes up the ocean. Each person is different, but they make up humanity. You're not 10 soldiers, and you're not pushing people around, and you're not manipulating them. Everyone has a free will choice. You choose faith or doubt. That is your free will choice. Neville Goddard left the big nugget of states of consciousness and how these are your beliefs. And you can change them, but to get to the heart of gold, to get to that state, is to flood your mind with the subjective, which is the seven aspects of God. And subjective is, looking at it subjectively. Don't look at the outside world. Look at, the world from an imagination standpoint, from an all-encompassing standpoint, from, standing at the top of the mountain kind of standpoint. And recognize that mind, science calls God mind. The mind can do anything. The mind can conceive anything. So it has, science has encompassed all three into one. The human imagination, consciousness, and the subconscious. We're rising. God and man is rising. Okay? It's okay. The baby can be left alone for an age. And I can go rest and just enjoy this. And we'll just all have a great time knowing it all comes from the same place and we're all having fun. So you are the vessel, man, the body, it's the vessel for God. Okay, man in the human imagination is the vessel for God. And they have to work together with God. So to do that, you focus on the seven aspects of God that the Bible tells us about, and other teachers, Emmett Fox and Dr. Murphy and many others, that you focus on the aspects of God, and this is you incorporating it into your state of being so that your responses become automatic. You are attuned and tuned in to infinite intelligence, knowing your part of that, you're all of that. You know, it's one and the same. It's a paradox. That's not a paradox. So today, it's about life. And knowing that love is underneath all of this. So it's love and life. And that's back to that primary, secondary. You know, the primary is love and the secondary is life express, you know, it's life. So that's, it's a wonderful life. I love life. God is life. Every time you start to think about that bill or, you know, how am I going to get out of this mess? No, God is life. Okay. I don't have to convince myself. And that's what all this digging into the details stuff is. And we can go there. It's fun. It is. But there's a lot of people that have contacted me recently. And they're looking at, you know, a dire situation. And it's really for these people. And it's mainly to understand that, you know, you just say, go have a little moment of quiet somewhere, have a good cry, whatever it takes, and say, I accept that this is all taken care of. I'm handing this over to you, Papa. This is all good. I accept it's all taken care of. I don't know how, I don't care how. Thank you. I know it's all taken care of. Now, you really do care how. And God knows that. He wants you to care how. So now you flood your mind with the aspects of God. And when you focus on life and that you love life and that life is wonderful, you're understanding that it's all life, all of it, each thing, everything is life. It's all love, it's all life, okay? And, you know, things are going to wear out around here. Everything waxes and wanes. You know, but that's how we make new stuff and have fun doing new stuff that hopefully make our lives easier. But in the end, we usually discover it was just six of one, half dozen of another. It did make our life easier, you know, and that's what we've been doing. And we have to recognize that all of that, making our life easier, is really been the goal the whole time. Because you already had it easy. All you had to do was ask for it. You know, and it's like the joke's on you. All you have to do is recognize that God is love and God is life. You know, God is mind. The mind is life. The mind is God. The mind is, you know, life. Mind is love, you know. I love life. You're flooding your mind and you're saying, you know, I recognize that science says that God is the mind. That's the same thing. Well, mind is life. The mind is great. You know, whatever rocks your world. You know, I prefer the imaginary, Bible-y way. That's just me, you know. But the science way also helps clarify it because you're growing up in the story of science. You know, if you want to vibrate love because you're a love magnet, this is all love and you got pulled out of that, you know. And you made a baby with the divine being. You know, that's the story of Zeus showering gold on the woman and here's Hercules. God is life. Mind is life. You know? And that comes back again to what do you want to represent? You know? I want to represent loving life. Life. All life matters. All of it. The ants, the birds, the bees, the flowers, the trees. It's all God. It's all mind. It's all imagination. It's all beautiful and lovely. You've been handed the reins here, but it's all God. You've been allowed to shape it any way you want, with what you flood your mind with. So if you spend 1 week flooding your mind with nothing but love and life and the love of life, knowing that your mind makes life, you're part of this, and then you just keep that focus, that bill's coming in your face, you're about to get kicked out of the apartment, you just, God is life, God is love, God is good always, life is good, life is sweet, life, and you're saying this in your head, that fear, that doubt will go away. When you focus on life, worries about being old, depression, you know, always getting angry, different things like that just melt away. The fear melts away. Doubt melts away. It's things like that. And it's love conquers all. So if you can focus on love, all of it comes through love. You know, these are not secondaries, though. These are aspects of God and just as important as the love. But it's the love that drives it all, you know. So I hope this helps clarify a little bit the mental diet you need to have when you believe you are in a time of trouble. You're having pain and suffering. You just need to turn your head away, okay? Turn the other cheek, all right? And focus on the seven aspects of God's being, because He's inside you. He has individualized Himself in you and in everyone else. And if you focus on love and life, no one can respond to you in any way except with love. And with life-bearing gifts. And what I mean by life is everything. You know, it to live a healthy, prosperous, rich, rewarding, wealthy, healthy, wise, fulfilling life. That's life. That is life. Those are secondaries. Okay? Focus on the primary. It's life. But recognize that all those things are life. And God is life. God is all those things. Those things are you already. They are in you now. They are the nature of God's being. All you're doing is putting on a state. You're putting on the state of being. The state of being. God. Okay? Which is love and life. So, the next few videos will focus on each aspect. And I've given you the most important one, which is love. So, just keep focusing on God is love and God is life. And I know this is all going to work out great. Love it, love it, love it. And I hope this helps. Blessings to you, and thank you. Thank you for being you.
No, no. Oh, all right. Didn't I get you already?
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. Come on.